Hello, and welcome to Italy.
That's a shame. There was a child in that when it first went in.
This looks really horrible.
Oh, cat bath.
Looking rather nice. So we're here now, which is pretty fantastic. We're in but it's by the beach, which is nice. Alison and Steve are here as well. It's kind of the reason why we're here as well, because they're getting married. And I don't suppose if you watched a video.
Alison, will you do me the honour of being my wife?
Just been to the shop, got a little something for the sea.
I am an English tourist.
So just getting to the end of the first day, and it's been really, really lovely. It's been nice to be on the sea. People are looking at me weirdly. Because I'm talking to my phone, because I'm a millennial. Yay! So, you might be wondering why I haven't uploaded much, but that's because, just a bit of a cheek. Ugh. Yeah, I haven't been uploading recently because I've been involved in a play, basically. It's called The Crucible, you might have heard of it. And that's been taking up most of my life, along with coursework. So yeah, just haven't really had the chance, but hopefully over the summer, should be good. I've loved every minute of the play though, and the people I've been working with have just been so amazing. It's just nice to have a relaxing weekend by the sea. Might go out to this bit of a river there. Might go out to a couple of islands tomorrow, which should be nice. Might even pop into Rome, but I doubt it. But it'd be cool if we did. Just off to dinner now with Alison and Steve, so I will see you later.
We are number one.
Just been for a cheeky little run, only a couple of miles there and back again, but that was alright. It was barefoot on the sand. I think one of the nice things about this place, something that gives it such its charm and its quirk, is that it's a holiday destination in Italy for Italians, not for bloody tourists like me. So it's like everything here is Italian. You know, you don't get any cheap rubbish from the Britons would want. That's really nice. So much faster. Some nice looking tomatoes.
This is my first attempt, yeah? Definitely not fifth.
At work, found my lucky stars, kissed a newborn babe.
Six.
First hole.
Sometimes the world
lies. Oh, you bastard.
one. My lucky pants found me gay.
Italy, famous for its Eiffel Towers.
Another lovely thing about this place is that it's very family orientated, so all of the kids are out with their parents. Everyone has a mum and dad with them, and it's lovely to see just a nice family holiday destination sort of thing. And because all the shops are closed in the afternoon because they all have siestas, I presume, and you know, just nap time in the afternoons, keep them cool, I guess. And so all the shops are open later, and yeah, everyone is just out with their mum and dad, which is just lovely to see. We found a nice bar which we get ice creams from and other drinks and nibbles and stuff, and I think they've grown quite fond of us because they've been giving us bits of discounts and good service, which is very nice, and they recognize us now. So yeah, off to Florence tomorrow, which should be fun. So yeah, it's a nice place. They're all frogs. Sorry, Adam Hill, you're not allowed here.
Just getting off this double-decker train.
We're in Florence!
The man himself, Michelangelo. Of course, the famous leader of the Teenage Mutant Ninja Turtles. Streets to keep the heat out, the shade, it works quite well. There's the Ponte Vecchio, literal translation as Old Bridge.
They're very nice. Would you like some tiramisu?
Tiramisu.
See, we're saving the planet. We're having cones rather than bowls.
My mum doesn't know how to eat ice cream. What is this? Nice German church. Martin Luther Garden School, and there's a man with some very short shorts. The old city walls. The only way is up. Nice old car show. There's a good doggo. That ain't this. I think the people of Florence have been playing too much Minecraft. They found a village where the door is about 5 blocks off the ground. Bugger! The castellations aren't correct. We'll have to add another one to the end. Well, there's Gordon, apparently, according to Mum. Perseus slaying Medusa. Who's a Gorgon? Not Gordon. Hi, Gordon. So some of these statues date back to the 2nd century. That is relatively old, I'd say. Almost as old as Dad. Hi, Dad. There he is. Time to paint some moons in the Rosenthal.
when you've been left hanging for the past couple thousand years. Griff, this would be you as a statue. Big child of fabulous. Tomato salad.
I'm a bit unsure of how anatomically correct this pencil is.
It's the end of a Sunday, and it's been quite a brilliant Sunday, to be fair. We went to Florence, went to see all of these sites, the gallery, which name I've forgotten, and it's a really famous one. I should probably remember it, and I'm going to put it over the screen now. Went to see the Duomo, but that was a very long queue, so we decided against it in the end. It's a really nice city, Florence, to be fair. It's very cultural. It's got the statue of Michelangelo, which is very nice. And the one thing I would say about it is very touristy. It's very touristy. It's like the place I'm staying at now, San Vincenzo, is very much an Italian tourist destination. So everyone speaks basically only Italian. There's a few English speakers here. You know, everything's written in Italian. It's really nice. We are in Italy. You go to somewhere like Florence, just the amount of English and American tourists just wandering around the place, and then everyone speaks English. Every sign is in both Italian and English underneath. So it's doesn't spoil it at all. It's obviously very helpful for an ignorant non-Italian speaker like myself. But yeah, it's definitely a very touristy place, and so crowded as well. But no, it was all in all a good day, and definitely want to go back there again. So tomorrow is now the wedding. So I won't film anything, but I'm going to put a photo reel of all of the pictures now. So we just had a wedding. That was rather nice. Congratulations to Alison and Steve, my neighbours, as the official photographer. So that was good fun. And It was a lovely day. It was a lovely day. If you've seen some of the photos, that's great. I won't be able to put all of them up, obviously, because I took about 200. But it's quite dark. There you go. But it was a really lovely service, a really lovely day. Heard about flash storms in Britain. Such a shame we're in Italy, you know. Such a shame that, you know, we've been having to take off all layers because of the heat, you know, and the sun. To be fair, it's actually just starting to drizzle now, so I have to get inside a bit. But it was a lovely day, and we're off to Elba tomorrow, hopefully, which is the island of my apartment. Very strong smell of jasmine. Lovely. So yeah, just going for drinks now, and showing the slideshow of all the photos. So that's nice. So I will see you later.
For the vlog, say hi.
Right.
Mi saluti, Kiko.
Hi, one.
I just flew in from the windy city. The windy city is my pretty belly. Got what we got. Thank you.
fishing here. I'm hanging by my thumbs in Zanzibar.
Let Tom Scott this thing, right. So this underpass is actually of some historical significance. So in the Second World War, the RAF decided to bomb the railway line that ran through the entire west coast of Italy. Where they decided to bomb it, they couldn't just bomb the entire thing, obviously. So they targeted the level crossings. So the cars couldn't get across. However, they missed the one in here, which meant that every single place that had been bombed then got an underpass, because underpasses are considerably more effective than level crossings. You don't have to cross a railway line where a train might run you over. Except for this one. So this underpass came only about 10 years ago, 10 to 15 years ago, and the residents here have blamed the RAF for not being accurate enough and for missing this one, for not getting an, as they didn't get an underpass. So there's a fun fact of the day.
Then enter the roundabout.